Hey guys, how's it going? Well, this was originally a project video and it got lost. The original video was a project of me redoing my setup here so like for editing. I've had some issues with sound problems in the past and I was retiring the old speakers there. Anyway, I did a mod on this Triton Pro. It's a headphone amplifier for gaming. I originally picked it up for $3, thinking I could modify and put a jack on this and use it as a headphone amp. Problem is, the headphones that go with that Triton are like this, where they have the amplifier on the actual wiring harness. So all that is there is a 16-bit dual DAC. And some Dolby stuff. But anyway, it's plug and pretty much plug and play in Windows. It detects right away. But the issue being that there's no amp in it was kind of an issue. So I really couldn't do anything with it. I paid $3 for it. Took it apart, ended up putting two RCAs in the back and finding out a way to ground the RCAs, and then I basically found the two outputs on the DAC that now are now hooked up to the RCAs, and it works good. I had a long video. I was testing all the ports and found the data line and everything else. It was a good video, and it got lost when I upgraded to Windows 11. I started messing around with the MBR, trying to get it so it's what did they say with the hard secure hard drive or whatever, and I got that to work. But in the process, it changed the hard drive and basically it wouldn't boot. And then I later found out that for whatever reason, my C drive was my E drive, and all my other hard drives were my computer was just so messed up. I don't even know how it even ran, to tell you the truth. But when I tried changing the hard drive for the secure boot, it basically destroyed it. So I had to redo that. And I lost all my footage, which totally sucks. Because, I did a big spiel on it, went online and was looking up how to do the secure boot. And so I went to DOS prompt and did all that there. And then the guy said, yeah, you just go into your BIOS and change your boot order to the UF whatever it is, and so I did that and it still didn't work. I like I said, I later found out that it was the hard drive itself. It was just set up so badly. So anyway, going on about this, it works good. It's dead silent. Get nothing. It's turned all the way up and it's loud. It sounds really, really good. I'm guessing that's a Dolby. The only thing that works on the outside of it is the power button. Something that won't give me a copyright strike, which is pretty much everything. Let me do one of my videos. Probably get a copyright strike. Guys, I figured I'd change. So yeah, this worked pretty good. Let me pull it out and let you have a look at the back and everything else. Yeah, so I basically just took it downstairs, drilled two holes, put two RCAs in it, and take it apart and let you see the insides. Yeah, it wasn't until after I redid the hard drive three times because it was so messed up that I realized I lost the footage. And the reason for that is it was a huge file and it was taking forever to upload, so I just basically canceled it. And I figured, yeah, I'll just come back to it. But I had no idea that I had copied the movie files to the desktop and not another hard drive. So it's my bad.
Get some light.
So there's my not so good wiring job. I got it grounded to the USB plug jack, and then the two, I can't really point them out too well, but you're in this area here. You just follow these traces down to there. I mean, there's different, like this one here is data. I'm not too sure what these ones over here are, but this one definitely has a tick, tick, tick when you hook anything amplified up to it, so definitely data. Yeah, that's it, and it works great. And this is your DAC up here. I'm not too sure what this stuff here is, but pretty much not using it anyway. But it was a nice video for modding, nice modding video, I should say. And I lost it. Bummer. Yeah, so I apologize about losing the data. But, I mean, it's very rare that I do any upgrades, and I'm hoping my future videos will get a little bit better. We're going to do a video on this, too. Pull this apart. It's a lot older than 16 years. I hope I can link. I'll put a link in the description of the video when I did repairs on this. It still works. I haven't had any more problems with these buttons here when I pulled it apart and cleaned it in the video, but the issue I'm having now is that jack in the back is acting up. And for the longest time, I was either ignoring it or kicking it when one side wouldn't work or whatever. I just got tired of it. So we're going to pull it out and inspect it. See what has failed and what is failing. I'm hoping it has a decent transformer and stuff in it. And then I'll just break it down and recycle it. But and again, I apologize for losing the video. That really sucks, but I mean, this is a way better setup. I was due for doing something in the way sound wise anyway. I originally wanted to put them on stands, but the desk is narrow and I don't think it would work. The only way I could do it was extend that pole there up and then put another one of those holders out and have a speaker here and over here. But it looked huge and stupid, so why bother? This works. I mean, they fit right underneath the monitors. And I mean, they are adjustable, because I actually modded that myself, so. But anyway, we'll see how the future videos turn out. Take it easy, and I'll see you in the next one.